Okay, welcome by my first YouTube live stream, and I'm in the Home Computer Museum in Helmond, and let's wait on some viewers. I have one viewer now, so hi, I'm in the, oh, and it's gone. So I have no viewers now, and I'm walking around. Hi, hey Martin, thanks. Hi, I'm in the Home Computer Museum right now, and today's the opening day, and it's the first live stream. I've never done this, so let's hope it's working. Hi, hello, Leon, Kone and Simon. Nice. Oh, and so many comments now. So let me show you around here. Here we have some shelves with old stuff that's on display. Old Macs and stuff. And here we have all kinds of systems, a Motorola PowerPC, an IBM system with Windows 95. And the system here, is the sound okay? Because I don't have a special microphone on this telephone. Nice hoodie, thanks. Is the sound okay? Check. Everything is good, nice. Here we have an iMac, and I know you all love Macs. The sound is okay, it's nice. Here we have more PCs. And a nice Tulip machine with Quake. And what are you doing now?
Trying to boot up Amazon.
MSN.
Only we don't have internet.
But you want to have a working MSN here?
Yeah, maybe one day we'll build a personal server or something.
Nice. Let's continue the tour. I think this will be a crappy live stream. Here we have more Macs. A system with a Roller Coaster Tycoon. And here's someone playing GTA 1. But let's go back in time a bit, because they have some old systems here. Look, welcome in the 70s. Here we have an Apple II system. And here we have an XD Sorcerer. And it is a 2.1 megahertz system with 48 kilobytes of memory. Very nice. And a nice old setting with nice old wallpaper. How can I see all the comments? Let's see how that works. Ah, nice. I can scroll through it. Are you from Kazakhstan? No, I'm not from Kazakhstan. Here we have an Atari 2600. And here we have an Radio Shack TRS-80. And it's not working right now, but they are still troubleshooting it. And here we have another Radio Shack TRS-80. And this one is kind of working. And they have modified this one with some extra switches and stuff. And here we have a cassette carousel. Really 70s. Victor is from Turkmenistan. No, I'm not. Here we have an Commodore PET and a nice look inside. I hope the light is okay here. And here we have a 5 megabyte hard drive. And it's really huge. And I don't know the brand of it. and some other hardware systems. So let's go further in time to the 80s, because they have here an 80s room with another Radio Shack TRS-80. A portable machine from IBM, another TRS-80, some kind of portable machine, and Kypro 4, and a Philips portable computer, and a Commodore CBM model 8032. And we have here an Osborne 1, and also a portable PC with some storage here for floppies. And here we have a Sony home computer, and Hitbit, and a Tandy 1000. With some nice trippy graphics.
Yeah, a small one.
Let me see if there are new comments. CRT, great items, compact portable, cassette cards. Nice. Here we have an Apple II. And another machine, and I don't know which one this is. Here in the middle we have MSX machines, more Philips machines, also MSX, an Atari 800, Commodore VIC-20, Texas Instrument TI-99, Radio Shack TRS-80, a 10,000, and BIT-90 computer. I never heard of it, but I'm more a PC guy. What's this? Oh, I think this is a BBC system. An Acorn, another Tandy, some kind of real portable machine, and Tandy 200. This is pretty small and lightweight, with external floppy drives.
The bouncables made of pure rubber. That's a natural material, just like rocks. So they work in my backpack.
So let's see. What's we that? Go now in the more 80s stuff. A Philips machine, an old Mac Classic, Atari, another Atari, and Tandy Color Computer 3 with a nice display and nice joystick, and what's this? An Head Start Explorer, never heard of it. And Fendex Head Start 2, a Toshiba laptop, another laptop, also Toshiba, and Amiga with an Amiga monitor, and under it there's a Tandem 286 under it. And I have a Tandem 286, I never shown it on video, but I still need to restore it. But I have a tower / desktop model. But that video will come someday. And a Commodore 64, and a Philips NMS 9100. And when I was a kid, I bought a system like that. I think I found it for free in the local newspaper, but it was not working, so I picked it up, but I never done anything with it. Let's see what we have here. an Amica and another Amica, and some graphic design is going on here. Another Tulip Compact One system, very nice. Let's see what we have here. Here we have some kind of Commodore CD TV, another failed Commodore product, an IBM PS1 with Prince of Persia. Great game, you really need to check this one out. More portable systems, and this one you can put a floppy drive in here in the display and then close it. Some kind of business Olivetti in a big suitcase. One of the early Dell laptops. Another Tandem 286. I have a tower like this, but mine has. I have a tower like this, but mine doesn't have the removable hard drives. I just have a normal floppy drive, but it's a model. The case is this size. So let's see what we have here. We have a Commodore 4000 Amiga system. Shelves with nice stuff. One of nice gaming joysticks. Commodore 64, SIP drives of course. A Sharp system. They have printers, more laptops, monitors. Let's see if there are more questions of Prince of Persia plays unfair as hell. Nice. Never knew Philips made computers. They made actually a lot of computers, but in the Netherlands they are known, but outside of the Netherlands I don't know how big they were. Please say how much for your wife. Those are really old. Nice. I just got here. Where's the museum located? Okay, let me explain where I am. I'm in the Home Computer Museum in Helmond, and it's just and today's the openings day, and here we have the guy that started the museum. You're now live on YouTube, and we have actually 34 viewers.
33.
Oh,
one doesn't like it.
No. Too bad. So how's your day going?
Mostly tired.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm really tired. Yeah, I've been working for this entire week for at least 15 hours a day.
Nice. Oh, Dr. Drex was here today.
Oh.
Hi, Dr. Drex.
Hi, Dr. Drex. I don't know him. No.
So you built this up in not many days?
No, in 8 days. We nice. Built this, everything here is built up in 8 days.
Cool. Including the floor?
Including the floor. We didn't do that, but...
But still, that was also in the 8 days.
Yeah, absolutely.
Nice. And where can they find more information about this museum? Because they were asking, where were you? I just logged in.
I'm at homecomputermuseum.nl. Ekarambal 81.
Hey, you know him?
No.
Oh, hey, but maybe they recognize you from the video.
Yeah, maybe.
Yes.
Yeah.
So what can they expect from this museum?
It's the best museum of the Benelux about home computers.
Nice.
Yeah. Most interactive and most fun. And
yeah, because there's a lot of systems you can actually play on.
All systems. Basically all, yeah. All computers are playable.
Some are not, I think the Osborne, there are not many games on it.
No, I don't have games for Osborne yet.
Maybe you can make them.
Helmond, this is at Helmond in the Netherlands.
Yeah. And Helmond is in the southern part of the Netherlands.
Yeah, not in Minnesota.
And also not in Australia.
No. Also not in Italy, but hi.
So I think I'm gonna continue the tour by the console area.
All right, it's there.
Yeah.
The arcade.
Yeah, the arcade. But here they have some parts for sale, some games for the MSX and ZX Spectrum, Amiga, Commodore 64, some Commodore 64s for sale, many joysticks for sales, also the SUSO, the arcade, and a US Robotics modem, 65K for 15 euros. So if someone wants to buy that modem, let me know, I will send it to you. Kids playing on the consoles here. We have a Philips VideoPak system, an Atari 2600, another Radio Shack. Here we have a photoplay unit, and they were in bars and restaurants to put your money in and lose all your money. But here you can play it for free. So when you buy the entrance, you can go in for free. When you buy the entrance, you go in and the rest inside is free. So you don't have to pay to play on a machine like this. The Halak. Here we have an arcade machine, and there are many games installed on it. So you can really easy play some games here. Nintendo stuff. And a Philips CDI system. And Sega Master System 2. A PlayStation 1. And a nice Apple banner logo. Super Mario, yes. So, what do you think about this museum and this nice little crappy live stream tour? So, I have a few questions. I can answer them. Epic Beardman, yeah. Looks awesome. Yes, it is really an awesome place. And they are just in the still building up stuff. So, the 90s collection here, for example, is not yet done. They gonna put more systems in and install more games on it, decorate more, put more old vintage cabinets in it with systems, and they really want to make rooms in this place to get the feeling of the early days, like this, the desk with the books on it and the lamp and all the stuff like this, and the old crappy chairs, just like the old days. There's a dark room too. Yes, I'm gonna show you that now. But first, let's see more questions. Please steal the CDI controller for me. I need one bad. Yeah, they are pretty rare nowadays. If I was there, I would go straight to the box of games. Yeah, there's great games in it, but not many PC related stuff for sales. The dark. It's awesome. Please do more videos, man. But Master System 2, is it a genius in the USA? I don't know. I'm not a console guy. I'm more from the PC stuff. But let me show you the dark room, because that can be pretty interesting for the future of the retro community in the Netherlands and the Benelux and Germany and stuff. Because here we go into the dark room, and as you can see, it's really dark here, and the Commodore documentary is now playing here. And to avoid copyright stuff, let's leave there. But the room there is possible to get make LAN parties in it. So we already, Dr. Drex and I already asked the owner to have LAN parties here, so we're gonna make that happen someday. And there's more people live streaming. I think live streaming to his girl.
Wait.
You're now on the internet, on YouTube. I just fixed a computer deal. So, I think I'm gonna end this live stream. It's 20 minutes now and 27 viewers. It's very nice. So, where is the button to end this? I see here a cross. I think if I press that, I will end it. So, thanks for watching this video. And I will upload a more vlog style with a better tour of this area with someone talking to the camera soon. So wait for that. And it was just a crappy tour and experiment if this is working. I have made a live stream that lasts 4 hours and 30 minutes. But then I think I die. So that's not a good plan to do it that long. Catch you in the next video. Wave, bye, thanks. Okay, thank you all for watching, and see you later. Bye. But I think you know.